I often think of the game Jenga, where you pull little wood blocks out until you pulled out so many the whole tower collapses. And the bees are just starting to come out. So I'll probably overwinter two hives this year. I had a third, and they lost their queen for some reason. You can't lose too many species in an ecosystem before you start to lose a lot of important ecosystem services. I'm Ken Bridle. I'm a full-time tree hugger. My father was a very avid gardener, and his mother was a very avid gardener. So this is kind of like poppy seeds. So that's what those guys are doing growing here. So I just grew up out in the woods all the time and turned into a plant physiologist by training. Climate change is causing the weather to be weirder, not as reliable. In my garden, I've seen my honeybees come out in the middle of winter and start flying around looking for flowers, and there aren't any. Apples are really a cool weather crop. It's also warmer in the wintertime, so the apple trees don't go fully dormant, which means they don't make buds like they should in the spring. Pick out any bad looking spots and applesauce. Almost any plant gets stressed either by drought or storms or temperature. I call it global weirding, because really it's more than just global warming, which is one of the things we see that's happening here in the park. I've probably been coming up to Hanging Rock for 45 years. I've worked to help build exhibits, narrated some park videos. Oh, this is home. The biodiversity in this part of North Carolina is pretty high because we're on the northern edge of the Piedmont and we're on the southern edge of the mountains. Hemlocks are an important part of the biodiversity of the park. Just above us is a waterfall. We have the Canada hemlock, which is usually down along the creeks here, so it doesn't really like hot summer weather. We're at the southern edge of the eastern Canada hemlocks range here in North Carolina. There's two species of hemlocks that grow in this park. When you look at the branchlets, the eastern hemlock's needles are kind of flat, and the Carolina hemlock needles stick out at an angle. They prefer to be in places, especially the Canada hemlock, that's more like Canada. When it gets hotter than it has been, or drier, we have droughts and high temperatures, they're stressed. Then that stress makes them more vulnerable to other pests.
My name is Mary Griffin. I've worked here at Hanging Rock State Park for about 7 years. So on the east coast of the United States, there's an insect. It's an aphid-like insect called the hemlock woolly adelgid. The adelgid is not native. So here, there's nothing to keep it in check. So it just goes wild. And it's specific only to the Carolina hemlock and the eastern hemlock. The adelgid in Hanging Rock is everywhere. You could go to any stand of trees and find it. And it's slowly killing off these trees. When we don't have the usual winters or the usual summers, then these insects are going to be active year-round, feeding and reproducing. And so that's just going to create a larger problem for the hemlocks in this area. This cup of water in this straw represents a healthy tree. So when I take a sip of the water, that's how water freely moves within a tree. The mouth parts of the adelgid pierce the branch, like a pushpin pierces the straw. I'm going to take a sip of the water and mimic. And so I was able to get very little water up because of these holes. And that's how the hemlock tree slowly starves to death, because they're not able to move the water or nutrients around the system. But the park staff has done a great job of treating those trees. So there's different treatments that we use here at Hanging Rock State Park. The chemicals we use on the hemlock trees is called imidacloprid, and it's essentially like flea and tick medicine you might give to your dog. We'll measure the diameter of the tree at breast height, and then depending on how big that tree is, it gets so much treatment. I'll use 19 ounces. We have a soil drenching method where we dissolve packets of insecticide within water. There we go. And then we'll pour it around the tree roots. So the tree takes it up through the roots. And so when the adelgid injects its mouth part into the branch, it sucks up some of that insecticide and then gets killed off. Chemical treatment is very effective. Usually about 3 years, they're good to go. We try to stretch it out just because the resources are limited to 5 to 7 years. Once a tree loses about 50% of its needles, it's probably not gonna make it. So we don't usually treat those. But you know, I have a lot of hope that the hemlock's gonna make it through this. Hemlocks are important because they have so many functions in our forest. It's a great habitat, and these limbs also shade the forest floor or the creek beds they're growing next to. It keeps the soil moisture constant. It keeps the water cooler, and cooler water holds more oxygen and drives algae levels down. So that's more oxygen that's available for fish, like trout. The trout are able to lay their eggs. The eggs like to be oxygenated. So this cold water is holding more oxygen. The eggs are staying viable. If we're not treating these trees, creek beds get a little warmer. We might start seeing some species migrating out of the area. We're gonna have a lot of dead trees in our forest, so you got more fuels on the ground. Wildfires.
A lot of climate change and a lot of impact on the environment is done by people who are unconsciously doing things, and if it doesn't take much for us to get conscious. There are things we know how to do, and the more people pay attention, the more those things get done. It's easy.